Tonight on Access Hollywood, where drug counselors once summoned Whitney Houston's Beverly Hills hotel room.
What happened? Give us a blow-by-blow.
The man who broke the story is in our studio with details on the day last year her mother allegedly intervened.
The Faith Hill exclusive. Find out what she told us about her husband, Tim McGraw, as new information surfaces about his high-profile arrest.
Bugs, bugs, and more bugs.
Guys, bon appetit.
Get ready to find out how far tonight's survivor will go as a controversy erupts with Millionaire.
We know why a multi-million dollar lawsuit was just launched against Mike Myers.
Rosie O'Donnell makes a startling admission about the future of her hit show.
She really wants to move forward in a different direction.
He trains the stars to the tune of 10 grand a month. Now, we give you his secrets for free.
Close your eyes and you'll bet it's Celine Dion. Is there room for another diva? Of course there is. Find out on Access Hollywood Wednesday, June 7th, 2000.
People are calling her Celine Dion's double. Access discovers a diva in training.
And another performer makes our third installment of Access Hollywood Discovers today. Toni Potts joins us to introduce us to a young lady people are confusing with two of the best singers in the world. Toni.
That's right, Sean. You know, if you've heard the song I Will Love Again on the radio, you've probably been thinking, wow, what a great Celine Dion song. Well, you'd be wrong, because the amazing talent is Lara Fabian.
I will love.
That voice has been compared to Streisand and Celine, but make no mistake, this is Lara Fabian. And this Belgian-born singer has already taken France and Quebec by storm. USA, well, you're next.
To me, USA, America represent that amazing dream, that amazing, beautiful success you can finally achieve after working for a long time.
And you don't know what I mean. Does it really matter?
Access Hollywood was on the set of Lara's music video for her explosive hit song, I Will Love Again, from her new self-titled English language debut.
There's an amazing challenge there to be able to be successful in a complete different country with a complete different culture.
Ah, but when you've been compared to these two power voices, stardom seems guaranteed.
The comparison is a very human thing. When people don't know what you are about, they will compare it to something they know to reassure themselves. And a comparison is the most normal thing, I believe, when you're starting.
I will love again.
Ah, she is amazing. Now, besides being a great singer, Lara also speaks four languages and has sold over 5 million French language albums. Her self-titled English debut is in stores now.
Still to come, are the sultry women of Sex and the City saving cable TV? And the music of French chanteuse Lara Fabian.
I will love again.
Back here live at Ellis Prop Shop. Now, when you hear the name Fabian, it generally conjures up images of surfboards like those old beach movies. But Lara Fabian is no stranger to success. She's been known in France for years. The French-Canadian songstress, however, is coming stateside. Jody Ross caught up with that other Fabian and found out about her English language debut.
I will love again.
You've heard of a triple threat. Well, 29-year-old Lara Fabian can do that one better. She sings in three different languages.
Perdere l'amor, d'autres façons de se quitter. Sola, sola, otra vez. Sola.
But it's her debut album in English. That's making her a star in the States.
I think you go, ah, when you say something like that. I'm very happy. Amazing, amazing.
What may be amazing are the many similarities between this singing sensation and another dynamic diva you probably know.
And You're both French-Canadian. You're both beautiful. You both sing ballad-type music. Do the comparisons, are they threatening to you? Do they bother you?
A comparison is a human thing and a normal thing. When Mariah first came out, she was a new Whitney. Bryan Adams was the new Joe Cocker. Oasis were the new Beatles.
She's new to Americans, but Lara's been famous in France for more than a decade. She even won a Victoire, the French equivalent of a Grammy.
Is that the kind of thing you'd like to win here? I mean, would that be important to you? Does that matter to you?
Of course. I'd be a liar. I'd be, oh no, you know, I'm not really into these things. I am. I am into whatever is a recognition because it creates a link with an audience.
Connecting with her audience is what Lara does best.
Her song is like really inspirational. It's really like, I don't know, just gets you in like the mood to dance and stuff. I think she's really good. I think she's very mature compared to like all the other artists out there. It's not like the Britney Spears or Christina Aguilera. I like it a lot.
The teen pop queens still have their place, but Lara Fabian is gaining on them.
I'm taking you over here because your single, I Will Love Again, is number one on the singles chart. Yeah. Come here. Right here.
Wow. That's amazing. Wow.
Feels good.
Feels great. Because it's been so many years, you know, it's Jesus. Understand if you care
that I am who I am. Jody Ross, CNN Entertainment News, New York.
Been waiting 25 minutes to do this. On this note, we're out of time, but remember, livebid.amazon.com. You can see all the items up for auction here at Ellis Prop House. Tomorrow, I'll be live on the set of Rock and Roll Jeopardy. We'll test your trivia in music. For Lauren Sidney, I'm Jim Moray. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
International singing sensation Lara Fabian is hitting the stage and singing her latest hit. All that and more next on The View.
I had this idea for a show. Different women. Different points of view. Maybe a little too different. We call it The View.
Future of music sounds like, don't move, because international singing sensation Lara Fabian is hitting the stage later.
I will love again.
Question for you. How many singers out there come with a money-back guarantee? Lara Fabian's record company is so sure you'll love her new CD that they'll give you a full refund if you're not blown away. She's already sold over 6 million records in Europe and Canada, and she's about to conquer the U.S. Please welcome Lara Fabian. Lara, thank you so much.
Thank you.
So, first of all, congratulations on all of your
thank
success.
You.
I understand that your first single has already hit number one on the Billboard Dance Club charts.
Yes, it's really exciting.
So has anyone called in on that money back guarantee?
Not home, personally. I didn't have that kind of phone call, but that number one was just so amazing. I had friends calling me all over the world. Clara, you realize this is happening. It's really cool.
You've already received so many accolades. I mean, people adore you, and you've been compared to Celine Dion and also to Barbra Streisand.
On the one hand, that's so flattering. On the other hand, does that put some pressure on you as a new performer?
You know, pressure comes along with this challenge. It does. So a comparison is a very normal human thing. I'm in very high company, I have to say. It's very honorable to be compared to these amazing talents.
Can you tell us something about the song you're going to sing today?
Yes, I'm going to sing a song about love, of course. What else can I sing about, anyway? And this is one of my favorite songs on the CD. It's called Love by Grace, and it relates to these women that will fight through a crisis, okay, no matter what happens.
Well, we're going to let you set up for that, and this is such a treat for us. Here to perform Love by Grace off her self-titled CD, here's Lara Fabian.
Good morning. The granddaughter of the Los Angeles police chief was shot and killed over the holiday weekend while she sat in her car outside an LA restaurant. The family is grieving in seclusion as the search for the killer continues today, Tuesday, May 30th, 2000.
From NBC News, this is Today with Katie Couric and Matt Lauer, live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
For the past several years, singer Lara Fabian has made a name for herself on the European and Canadian music charts. Well, Mark Anthony, Mariah Carey, and Ricky Martin move over. Now Lara has recently recorded her first self-titled English language album, and it hits stores in the U.S. today. Lara Fabian, bonjour. Good morning. Nice to see you.
Thanks for having Thanks for having us. How are you?
You're fine, thank you. Congratulations, because I understand your single hit the Billboard charts here in the United States, which number one,
yes.
Which is very, very exciting.
Very excited, absolutely. It's
obviously
really great.
People have heard you on the radio or have begun to hear you on the radio. How would you describe your music for people who might not be familiar with it?
I would say very, very passionate with an edge.
Yeah.
And something that mainly will reflect who I am as a woman.
And what about the tempo? Do you do mostly ballads or faster songs or everything?
It's very versatile. If you listen to the record from track 1 to 13, you really have many, many colors. And really, this is what I would like to believe, that people will be left with all these colors, not just one thing that will stamp me down, but just all these different things.
I know you're French-Canadian. You're enormously popular in Canada and extremely popular in Paris as well.
Actually, because my mother is Italian and my father is Belgian, and I'm based in Canada, so my European origins also made that possible.
And what will you be singing for us this morning?
I Will Love Again and Adagio.
All right, Lara Fabian.
Thank you.
Did I ever tell you how you live in me? Every waking moment, even in my dreams. And if all the stalk is crazy, just as long as I believe, I will love.
Even if
Fabian coming up, but first, this is Today on NBC. Fabian's background is opera. Your next song is?
Adagio, classical piece of music that remade into a contemporary way. Adagio, an old classical piece of music.
Okay, great. Well, thanks again for coming by this morning. What a great way to end our Tuesday.
Thank you so much. And these are all my musicians.
Well, they're terrific,
nice
too.
Job.
Once again, Lara Fabian.
Life fades away before I run out.
entertainment news program in the world.
A Tom Cruise exclusive is the top Hollywood story for Friday, May 26, 2000. Hi, everyone. Mary Hart is off. I'm Julie Moran.
And I'm Bob Goen. And with she has been compared to Barbara Streisand and has been called the next Celine Dion. But with a hit single, Lara Fabian is now making a name for herself.
I Will Love Again has landed Lara at number one on the dance charts, but it's her dramatic musical style that has critics and fans comparing her to another star.
If this is how the comparison is established, it's pretty positive and amazing, and I feel honored.
E.T. caught up with Fabian at New York radio station WKTU during a promotional stop, where she had the opportunity to meet American fans for the first time. And while the 29-year-old speaks four different languages, she relished the chance to pen lyrics in English.
Not only can you say something really deep, but phonetically it will end up into some smooth musical sound.
Lara's self-titled debut English album hits stores next Tuesday, and she looks forward to the perks that singing stardom has to bring.
Was hard, really. It's a luxury problem. What, that I have to wake up really early in the morning and go to bed really late because people want to hear this music? I've dreamt of this. And if I'm tired, I'll rest later.
Now, Lara's great sound may be new to Americans, but in Canada, her four previous releases have sold more than 6 million copies.
The time now, 7:49. Up next, listen to the voice that many say could be the next big diva. All right, first there was Tina and Whitney, then Mariah and Celine. Fox's Amy Scott looks into the making of a new diva. Her name, Lara Fabian. I will love.
The word diva is being tossed around a lot lately.
I don't understand. I mean, diva is a classy, beautiful word that will normally translate longevity, passion, voice, and loyalty to music and sincerity.
Diva has come to mean many things through the years. I think now it's perceived as a powerhouse vocalist. She arrived here that way, so I think it is, she can definitely rightly be called a diva.
She may be too young to be an official diva, but Lara Fabian's well on her way. She's got the looks, the talent, and an incredible marketing machine to back her up.
Roll sound, roll camera.
Clear. She went through a major bidding war to get signed in the U.S., and Sony's the one that captured her. And if there's a label that knows how to break big female singers, i.e. Celine Dion, Sony Records is definitely the one.
Born in Brussels, raised in Italy, this 29-year-old singer-songwriter is already a huge success in France and Canada, where in the last 2 years she's sold over 6 million albums, all leading up to American success.
USA, for some reason, has always been and is the cherry on the sundae. It's what everyone is looking at. And if you can, as they say, if you can make it there, I guess you could do it pretty much anywhere.
To prepare for her English language debut album, Sony spared no expense. They set her up with some of the greatest producers and composers in the business. The publicity machine is now in action. She's getting very used to primping and prepping and meeting and greeting.
Lara has a very busy season ahead of her. There are so many steps that an artist has to take in terms of showcases, in terms of publicity, in terms of advertising, interviews, going to radio, going on television, working to get on VH1 and MTV.
Every other day I'm in a different country. I take minimum 6 to 7 planes a week.
Oh my God.
Sometimes I can be in 3 different countries in one same day.
Oh my God.
That happens. I am who I am.
So is Lara Fabian destined for divadom? And will she be a good diva or a bad diva?
Today, when you speak the word diva, most of the time, it will remind to the people that you don't like the color of the limousine or the caterer, and you have a tremendously bad attitude. So why should this word be misused like this? So to me, a diva nowadays, the way it's been used, is really, really wrong.
So I would assume you would not like being called a young diva.
You know, I'm just a songwriter with a voice. That's all I am. Understand if you can.
Amy Scott, Fox News.
Not bad at all. Good voice. By the way, her new CD comes out today, and she will be at Carnegie Hall in September.
To the early show on this Tuesday morning. We're still waking up John Roberts inside here.
But... 17 minutes after the hour, with the summer fast approaching, Lori Hibbert has a few suggestions on how you can be hot and cool at the same time in this morning's Hib List. Lori, good morning.
Not an easy thing to accomplish, John, but we're going to try today. What to watch, where to go, and most of all, what to wear this summer. It's a Hib List summer special, starting from the bottom up. Next on the list, entertainment, always a summer priority. And whether you're going out or staying in, trust me, you are covered. Love Shack is a
little place where... If you're looking for kitsch, look no further. Party bands, the B-52s, vacation all I ever wanted, and the Go-Go's are launching a national tour on July 7th in Detroit. This is definitely the retro concert to see this year. But if it's new music you want, Lara Fabian's debut album hits stores today. I will love a girl, even if it takes a lifetime to get over you. The Belgian singer has been compared to Streisand and Celine Dion and is definitely a star on the rise. Want to avoid summer reruns? Why not try the hottest comedy on cable when a new season of Sex and the City starts this Sunday?
Women really just want to be rescued.
There it was. The sentence independent single women in their 30s are never supposed to think, let alone say out loud.
I'm sorry, it's true.